It's closer kind of thing, or earlier than, I'm sure they're gonna go head-to-head in the two. I don't see Lebecky as a factor in the two anymore.
I don't think she'll swim that.
I don't think so. Some relay.
Yeah.
Who do we have?
Yeah.
You?
Okay.
I hope.
Yeah, hopefully.
What are our four girls, what do they go? What are the top four girls in America go? Who are they and what do they go?
Lebecky, one of the three, best time, really know. Sims is up there, 155, Weinstein, 155, Chapel, 156, Kowalski is 6, 07, 1370, maybe a couple 156, you know.
There are?
Yeah.
So we don't want 156, won't make this relay. 156, better than that one.
Yes.
But you don't have to go 155 to make the relay, you don't think?
At the meet, probably, but at trials with the trials factor being that 17% of the people that go to trials off time, they do less.
Wow.
Like, it's always a toss up what it's going to be. I think it's going to be really fast. This year, I think it'll take a 156, maybe 155 to 50, but.
To make the team any individual back.
Make the team in the relay.
Oh, really?
Top four will be 5, and it just depends on what 5 and 6 go.
Top two are who?
Lebecky
and Sims?
Lebecky, Sims, and Weinstein.
Okay.
Because Lebecky will bow out of like the individual, so if she gets top two, then that opens another spot for 7.
So you average 108s in your 30 or 60 or whatever, 100s. What did they average? Weinstein and Sims.
I don't really know for sure, but they're definitely going a lot faster than I was.
Yeah.
Yeah. I only ever did 60 once, and that's best average. Not best average, just an example, best demo.
Okay. And you progressed from what to the way?
I only did the 60 ones one time.
Okay.
So
did you go out 30 once?
Yeah. I did 30 a lot, and I got down to 106.
106 on the average for 30. And then what did you average for the? This is your average.
Yes.
And
No, 1-6 was the average, 1-6 was the interval.
1-6 was the interval, what did you average?
1-2, 1-3.
And what do you average in?
And it wasn't like hard, 1-2, 1-3, it was just make the base.
Yeah,
like,
of course.
Cruising.
Yeah, that's, you know, we call that critical velocity. I was speaking on that before Ron ever even started pushing. So, yeah, he told me he started when I stopped. I was in Nevada also.
Oh,
I was in Carson
cool.
City back when he was good. So we had a lot of business from him. They weren't as good as his now, are now. They're better than his. For a long time. And he just kept getting better and better and better. Bond just keeps getting better. I think if he adds this component, he's going to be pretty darn good.
I mean, I feel like this is, his stroke, like the kids that he has already, their stroke like starts at the base of their program. So like they develop that all throughout, and by the time they get to Iran, they're already pretty solid in their stroke. I showed up and I was a trainer, so I needed the extra help, I guess.
Well, you know, Weinstein, I don't know, you know probably her background, right? She trained in New York.
Yeah.
For a really, Carly is just an amazing stroke coach. And she was the stroke coach for Kate.
Yeah.
Kate Douglas too. So she's really good, and we're good. We've become friends, and we've done videos together, Zooms together, and everything.
Mm-hmm.
So my question for her is, what do you do? What does she do? She has, coincidentally, communicators on everybody, every day, every single workout. You have to buy one to join the team. Did you know this? She's talking to them the entire time. I have a video of her doing it. I have it right here. Let me see it. Of them the entire time, from the time they're age groupers all the way up. Claire had these on her every single warm-up, every single workout, all the time, 100% of the time. Gotta be like, people are like, I would never want to do that. I can't get David Johnston to even hear me much of the time on these things. But they do work. But that's how picky. So when I first saw Claire, was it Lama Rada or Mata?
Yeah, I was at that meet.
Were you at that meet?
I was at that meet.
I see her warming up, and you know, I got this eye, and I went there to talk to him. So we sit down, we were working on the software. So he happened to be in town, and I'm like, okay, I'll hang out. So we're there for lunch. And then it goes over to lunch, and it's an hour or something, and then our motor coach sat down with us, and he does a lot of this tracking and stuff too. So we're just going crazy talking to each other. Then I watch warm up, and yeah, there's Bella, and there's all these great swimmers. I didn't want to watch them. As soon as I saw Claire take a stroke, one stroke, at her height, I went, oh my God. And she just moves from the very first thing she does. thought, oh my God, that's your best swimmer. She goes, he goes, yeah, I kind of think so too. you know, he likes them all, but.
Technically, Claire is great. She's so efficient in the water. Like, we would do, like, stroke count, whatever, like, seeing how efficient you can be in practice. And she's definitely the most, like, pulling wise and kicking. Who's a great kicker? No, just pulling wise. She's so strong, especially in the front. Like, I'd be swimming next to her, and she'd just go, shoot, from the get go. I'm like, oh my God.
Yeah, so, yeah, she's something. And but, you know, getting back to the point of, can you catch her? Man, I don't know. You're gonna be a fun test case. I think it's a great thing to do. You've got time, you're a freshman in college. I wouldn't let this Olympics go by without giving it your best shot.
Yeah.
But if you have all of these things that you can do better, I don't know what else I was gonna show you, but I think, but let's go with now, we'll go from with analysis to description.
Okay.
The thing I showed you yesterday, where you work on your extensors on your hips, pulling back. You can do it with tubing, it's better with isokinetics, but you can do it with tubing, get stronger. To me, if you don't measure it, it doesn't improve nearly optimal. So there's gotta be some way to measure it. Could it be, we have a thing, we'll show you there, kicker where you're kicking between, again, you can't measure it. I don't like that. But that's one of the things we want. If you pull away from the only problem is making it balance, but if you pull away from a weight stack with an ankle cuff, that should be better. That starts to progress, and I would start to measure it just to see what you can do. Be careful about it.
Yeah.
And make sure you're doing enough on the other side probably, but just make sure it's kind of balanced. And I can give you a ratio, and so can call in Dr. Leon when she comes in. There should be a ratio of strength there. You're probably weak. So let's watch your legs really quickly here, just to go. That was something we didn't talk about. We did with the dolphins. It's pretty much always the same. So I like to get that first kick off the ball to see what you think about kicking. So in this position, you're dragging. Now you're starting to kick down. We've seen your hip fire, which I like that. I like to see that happens first. Let's see when you do it. It's not that you do it, it's when. Couldn't you kick from here? You can't kick air anyway. Right?
Yeah.
So the only reason that you would kick any higher, theoretically, would be that you're rotating and it's rotating you up, but I would keep it lower into the water. Let's see how perfectly they do it, because I don't think they do it perfectly. But it's not bad. Yeah, there's not a lot of kicking going on there. But what she does do is almost all in the water. Look at her talent right now. I think her kick is doing what yours is doing. I think O'Callaghan is a little more efficient there. If anything, it's not in her way. People always talk about the finishing kick. What they don't realize is it's still only 10% of your propulsion, even at full blast.
Yeah.
I'll take 10%. I'll take 10% of your 200 time.
Yeah.
But it's not all that does it. It's really the summation of your hand going in and your foot coming down at exactly the right time and it not being in the way. This is lined up. Look at the ankle flexibility there. Not surprising. There you can't tell it because she's in the middle of it. Now let's look back at you. Let's see what it looks like. This is what I was really thinking. I think it needs to be tighter. And I think the reason it isn't tighter is you're not as strong here. And your gluteus maximus, medius, and minimus, and all that stuff. And also your quadratus lumborum. Those muscles will be improved with hip extensor exercises.
Yeah.
And then because you're doing the exercises and you get yourself at least a little bit sore, you should start to feel that as you're doing kick sets. Kick sets on a board aren't bad unless you're cheating. And here's why I say it. Is as a scientist, if you're thinking about how fast you're going and kicking today and how fast you're going and kicking in May, you're beginning to think about tapering.
Yeah.
I mean, long course. If you're cheating just a little bit more or you're not measuring it at all, it won't be there when you need it.
Yeah.
But if you start doing it scientifically now, so even at back flutter kick, if you go back flutter kick in a streamlined position, don't turn over and turn. It's not the way you're going to turn anyway, because you're going to be crossing over and doing a freestyle.
So it's like just one stroke.
I would not do any turn, any strokes. What I teach people to do is kick into the wall and bucket turn.
Oh.
Because then I know it's all kicking. Also, coming off the wall on flutter kick, measuring when we're doing the track set. We'll do this today. You're going to see, you're going to be a counselor. learn. And these kids don't know it. A lot of them don't. Some couple of them do. Is you come into the wall on your hands, and your spin turn could over the season maybe get a little better, but it probably will get pretty good in the next, you know, do it for a week. You start reaching down a little bit and just spinning and coming out. No dolphin, because that's a variable. So now we're talking scientifically. I know you're not a scientist, that's not your major, but we have to start thinking, okay, what makes us better is eliminating all variables and making that one thing we're working on get better for real.
Yeah.
Not trying to, better than the swimmers or whatever. Even when I saw, who was it from Virginia that went 54 flutter kick?
Walsh
went 54. But she also turned around and did turns. Now, to be fair, she did exactly the same turn every time I saw her do it.
Yeah.
So, you know, she always does it the same exact way in grade. But she might not. One day you might just pull a little bit harder. That doesn't tell me the legs are better. Because if you drop a second or two in flutter kick, in 100 flutter kick, that's a big deal. That's something you can depend on in your race.
Yeah.
Second or two gets a big deal, especially when you win by 100.
Yeah.
So I had a backstroke very called out just when I was there. When I first got there, they were NAIA. And he was a tall 6'6" guy, twin from Mexico. And I said, I want you to treat your stroke like, because again, tall, he's winning because he stood off the walls. He's, you know, he can float in and all this other. His ankles weren't that great, so he worked on it. Flutter kick wasn't great. Because the height, the length of the lever, it makes it harder for you to be a better kicker. That's why you see shorter people with a shorter lever and they got this turnover. But when you do, then you're really great. I mean, I grew up with basketball players like Kareem Abdul-Jabbar, who's this tall, skinny guy.
Yeah.
Today, he can push all over the place.
Yeah.
But we've learned to make taller people better. I said, there's other machines that have made taller people better. It's really, bench press was always held, bodybuilding was always held by shorter people with short limbs, because it's just not as much to move. You have it harder. And the reason I bring it up is, because you're a backstroker and a sprint freestyler, the legs are so important to you, and this can't happen very much, okay? You gotta tighten them up. And the faster you try to turn them over, when you try to change the angular momentum, it's harder than just doing one really hard one.
Yeah.
It's the change that makes it harder. So the prescription for back flutter kick is, first of all, do you know your back flutter kick time? All by itself?
Flutter on my back.
From what?
Flutter on my back,
yeah.
Just like kicking.
Or in front, you know, yeah. But back
flutter. Yeah, and I was in the waters.
You were a dolphin.
Yeah, I was in the water.
Yeah, so what is it?
Like short course,
my
best time
is
57.
Yeah, okay, 57 with flip turns and
flip turns and overwhelms.
Okay, so something there, especially when you look at 54.
Yeah.
Oh my God! And then I think Kate Douglas in that video went 59 and made a big deal about it. So Kate Douglas can go faster than 59 at that date, but I don't think she can do Walsh. Yeah. So in flutter kick alone, but you put the whole thing together and you get the idea. Now, if we do this more scientifically than them, we beat them. So the effect of this little talk here is we're trying to beat everybody.
Yeah.
So what do they do wrong? I think that's a little unscientific. It's a little wrong. What's great about that coach? You've seen him. He's got a great personality. A lot of times we get coaches with great personality. That's 95% of what we do. If you don't think if you're not happy, you're probably not going to. Even if you make the Olympic team, but you're not happy. I think about that. Who do you think the best backstroker is in the history of the backstroke? Christina Abramson. I'll answer it for you. You know
okay.
Who she is?
No.
When you see her stroke, I'll show you her stroke sometime. I can show it to you now, actually. When you see her stroke, you're going to go, your mouth will drop open if you know what you're looking at. Amazing stroke. I show guys that stroke. I tell guys, if you have that stroke, a guy that has that stroke will blow the world record away. Just blow it away.
Yeah.
Someone did. Just blow it away. But nobody can do it because when we keep thinking taller people are faster, we keep kind of cheating. I think we're sort of cheating on you. You're ready to make, we're close to make, the national team and everything. Nobody's even filming it, so it's my politics. But it's more than politics. It's real coaching. So if you're really coaching yourself now, when you do flutter kick on your, if you're going with a board, you don't pull into the walls. You kick into the walls. So just kick in, let go, and grab and go. As fast as you want to make that spin turn, cross your feet, everything you do because you have to do on them. So cross your feet and make sure everything's fast. Make sure your feet plant, shoulder width apart,
yeah.
Toes, but heels off the wall, which I didn't just see. Heels off the wall, all that stuff, great. Make those turns great. He makes people go underwater on the initial part, that's
yeah.
Great. But if you're doing flutter kick, do flutter kick.
Yeah.
Okay, so let's get 100 times of that. I've got some guys here doing 400s, but they don't do it very often, but 400 flutter kick because they're forwarded and up here, basically.
Yeah.
But I want to see that come down, 50 come down, 25 come down. I always say, how do you know you should do dolphin kicks underwater? You do dolphin kick for 25, what's your best underwater dolphin kick?
10-7.
And what's your best, that's on your front? Mm-hmm. And what's your best 25 fly, for example? Oh, 25-3.
10-6.
So you should be kicking underwater.
Yeah.
But there's other people, when you see in the camp, there should be people underwater and you're like, that person's got ankles like solid as a stable, and yes, let's get him up and swim. Titmus, up and swim. It's not like she doesn't have a good kick, not like she has some flexibility in your ankles. Getting her up and swimming is what we prescribe for you. If you can handle it, you know, if you're a good anaerobic swimmer already,
yeah,
let's put you underwater, but let's make sure we do the thing we did yesterday. Well, we did the vertical, and then you went to do that, it looked better. But after we did that is what we're seeing on video.
Okay.
So it's not an instant fix. Okay. So prescription, flutter kick, reeling for time, no variables on the front and back. Dolphin kick on the back and the front for time, no cheating. So again, no pulling of the ball with the kickboard, no turning over and flip turning. It may drive your coach crazy. You can tell them why they're doing it. Because you're going to want that underwater dolphin kick to be world beating, not just, right? So if you're not trying to beat the world, you're just trying to beat the other people at USC, that's great. And maybe you have somebody there. Who's your fastest backstroker?
At USC, Sprint, we have a Caroline Fayas. She's 51 low. Yeah.
What's her meters?
I'm
doing your music. She breaks
a minute? I don't know. She's kind of just college.
Huh?
She's kind of just college.
Oh, sure. So, yeah, that explosiveness is really tall.
Mm-hmm.
So she's getting walls.
Walls are 15 meters every time.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, but, I mean, she jumps really good off
yeah.
the walls.
Yeah, so she just does 100.
Yeah.
She's
me too. Okay. Yeah, well, good. Race her.
Yeah.
And try to beat her underwaters. If she doesn't do it legally, then try to beat her anyway, but beat you.
Yeah.
So we track, here. We track, this is terrible, because this is our camp, and we only track the 400 I am so far. But we track, you see here, 3100 is for you.
Yeah.
You can track anything, just when you track it, make sure it's right for you. So let me describe for you. How important is the 100 to 200 I am?
I won't do it, it's the same day as the 5.
You swim the 5-3?
Yeah, my NCAA lineup's probably going to be the 5-3 before I move to the backstroke.
Okay.
But long course, I have the 200 focus.
Trials, 200 free?
200 free, 400 free, and I have a mile, but I don't know some of it, and I have 2 half.
Okay.
Yeah.
So we're just getting started with that.
Yeah.
So let's pretend it's the 200 free. 3x100 free predicts to about 0.95%. What are you going to do in the 200? So if you go 3x100s, I go about 3 minutes. Some people do it, or Banachek used to do it on like at 6 or 8, and he would literally predict it from that. I'm like, really? Like, it's Banachek. So if you know who John Banachek is,
yeah.
So I always listened to him. I didn't follow him. I didn't have enough time. I was wanting to go distance. I'm a distance sort of guy. But, because that's a lot of time. 18 minutes to go 300. Wow, you know, you're driving him crazy. But anyway, I do it on 3, it doesn't really matter, but whatever you do, do it again, and again, and again. And no closer on these lactates, that's my prescription, than every 72 hours. So the aerobic stuff, which you like the aerobic races anyway, tons of mileage, but then about every 72 hours you can get away with going some really good alactic stuff that makes you fast. Just make sure you're doing it the way you want to do it. And if you're looking for a 56, you're looking for a 58. Okay. So 58, you start pushing 58, long course. How often do you guys train long course?
Morning practices.
Every morning practice. Well, let's see.
And Saturday.
Huh?
And Saturday. 40.
Saturday?
Yeah.
How many hours Saturday?
Two.
Okay. And you're limited to 20, with the 40 hours?
Limited to 20 hours a week, but sometimes in the mornings I'll stay and actually have a listen to guys a little bit extra.
Totally legal to do that.
Yeah,
as long as you're a coach.
Yeah.
So I'm sorry. Okay. So,
yeah, I got you.
3x100 free. So, you know, we're looking at 58. If I were to give you that set right now, what would you average? Right now, I mean, I know you're out of shape. You're not out of shape, but you're sick.
Yeah.
But would you average sub double?
Yeah.
Okay. And would you average 58s?
I would guess around there.
58 high. And you should be 156.
See, I have noticed that I'm really good at practice. I'm really fast in practice, and then if I get to the races, and I either take it out too slow and have so much less in the back end, which is what happened at nationals and finals. Finals, I was out too slow. My last few was 30.1, and I was like a little bit off the time out in prelims.
Right.
And if I had gone the time out in prelims, I would have made the Pan Am speed, which is so frustrating, but I'll get over it.
So you went faster in the prelims, and you went so.
I was 58.7 in the prelim and took it out too slow in finals and was like 005 on the way back in finals. And I was 159.1.
005 on the way back. Two things, which suck. One, you just said it's mental. But look, if I'm trying harder, let's go back to this. If I'm trying harder, what am I going to do more? Well, you've got this feel for pressure right here. If I try harder right now, I'm going to push down right now because that's all you can do right now. Okay? You can look at that or that.
Sorry,
<yeah. laughs> if you press down, you're not going to go faster.
Yeah.
You only go faster here. So it's possible when you're more fluid and you're more relaxed and you're doing a lot of workout and you're kind of tired anyway, that you're letting this sort of float and then maybe you're not taking the time to rotate the shoulder in. We're going to start working on making sure when you lay that arm in, no matter whether you're warming up, warming down, sleeping, I don't care, all the time, when you lay that arm in, the shoulder is immediately rotated.
Yeah.
This is not hard to do. Do it again for me. Just right there. Now bring it back, shake it off. Put it forward. Yeah. Okay, try again. Yeah, feel it?
Yeah.
And now when you pull, I want you to feel what you're going to pull. You're not going to feel lats. Here, look at, watch your lats here. Yeah, watch your lats. Your lats and chest are stronger. So now this is a function sometimes of going a lot of mileage too. Your lats and shoulder and chest are stronger. So right here, you see your lats just flare, right? Just getting pumped right there. But lats aren't what make you go faster. They are. They help. Absolutely, they help.
Yeah.
But your shoulder rotator, if you think about that from the very beginning, you set it up here, now you go to chest and lats. Here is much more rotators. So more than ever, if you change your stroke this way, I'm going to say this for everybody in case she blows out her shoulder and it's all my fault. She has to work the backside of her shoulder. She has to work on this. Like, this is the most important muscle.